Most of us use Termux in a non-rooted Android device, and sometimes we require root access to execute some programs in the Termux application. So in this video, I will show you how you can get root access or be a root user in Termux without actually rooting your Android device. So for that, this is my Termux and we will be using Fakeroot for this. But let me clear one thing, that Fakerooting does not do that much things that a real rooted phone will do. It can only be used to trick some programs to run that requires root access. For example, I've got Wi-Fi. See here, I got Wi-Fi. So let me just get inside Wi-Fi directory real quick. And here there is Wi-Fi.py. And if I will run Wi-Fi.py, see Python 2 Wi-Fi.py. See, login as root or try sudo. See, we need to be root user to run this Wi-Fi.py file. And right now uname, you can see if you are a root or not. You can see not uname, that is you can use who am I, not uname, you can use who am I to see who are you. And right now, as you can see here, that is I am U0A415, not a root user. I am a normal user, not a root user. So how can we trick this application to run using the Fakeroot? We will be using Fakeroot. But before that, let me show you one cool trick that you guys can use if you don't use this extra special keys that are provided from Termux. All you have to do is to press your volume up button and then the K button. See, disabling terminal toolbar, and it will disable this toolbar. And if you want to enable it again, just press volume up button and then again K button and it will be enabled again. So this is good thing. And for this cool shortcut, don't forget to like this video. Now, coming back to our Fakeroot. So to install Fakeroot, oh wow, what the heck, I have enabled plain mode. Let me just disable it because we will require internet access here. So to install Fakeroot, all you have to do is to type apt install and then Fakeroot. This will install Fakeroot. As you can see, reading Fakeroot is already the newest version. I have already installed it. So after you install the Fakeroot, but if you are using a new Termux, don't forget to do apt update and then apt upgrade, this command to upgrade the list of packages. And after it is done, all you have to do is to use this apt install Fakeroot. Let me show you one more time. Just close and then I will do, just you guys do yes to update all those packages, but I don't need it right now. And then just install Fakeroot by apt install Fakeroot. So after Fakeroot is installed, all you have to do is to type Fakeroot, as you can see here, and this will make you a root user. Right now, if I will do who am I, as you can see, I'm a root user. And back then, what I was, where was it? Who am I? I'm a U0A415. And now I'm a root user and there is our Wi-Fi.py. So let's run that file by typing Python 2 Wi-Fi.py. And as you can see here, we ran this program. We no longer see like you must be a root user, but we don't have the program that is required to run this program, that is aircrack ng. So that's what you can do with Fakeroot. Just trick programs to run as a root even though you are not really a root user. And now to get outside of root user, because if I will try to install something, see apt install something, for example, let's write something. It is not some application, but it won't install, I know that. See, what we get is ability to run this command as a root has been disabled permanently for safety purpose. So we need to get outside of Fakeroot to run all of these programs. So for that, all you have to do is to type exit. As you can see, let me show you first, who am I? Who am I? Oh, what the heck? Who am I? And I'm a root user. And let me exit. And now who am I? I'm a U0A415. So this is how you can install Fakeroot in your Termux user and use it to trick some programs or applications to run as a root. And then to exit from root user, just type exit button and you will be out. So that's it for this video. I hope you have found this video informative. Don't forget to drop a like. I will see you in next one.